Good morning. Welcome back to KVT Nausanabhag Vishakhapatnam grammar classes. Today class is on past perfect continuous tense in past tense. So we will learn the structure and uses of past perfect continuous tense today. Okay. Now we'll see the structure first. What is the structure of past perfect continuous tense? Structure is subject plus helping verb plus been plus V1 plus inform means V4 plus object as usually. So, what is the helping verb used in past perfect continuous tense? That is had. Had is used as a helping verb in past perfect continuous tense with all these subjects. I, we, you, they, he, she, it. With all these subjects, we had to use had as a helping verb plus been. Plus V1 plus inform means V4 plus object. This is the structure of past perfect continuous tense. Is it clear? Now, we'll see one example. We had been singing before he came. We had been singing before he came. So, had been singing past perfect continuous tense. As usually, we'll see the three kinds of sentences in past perfect continuous tense. They are affirmative sentences, negative sentences, and interrogative sentences. First, affirmative sentences. Affirmative sentences means according to the structure. For example, the children had been playing before the bell rang. The children had been playing before the bell rang. So, had been playing is past perfect continuous tense. See here, these two actions took place in the past only. These two actions took place in the past. But the first work had been going on before the second work took place. Have you observed this? The first work had been continuing before the second work took place in the past itself. That is called past perfect continuous tense and affirmative sentences means positive sentences according to the structure. Now we will see negative sentences. Yes, negative sentences means nothing but not is added to the affirmative sentences to make negative. But we should know where should we add not. In between subject and helping verb, or else in between helping verb and been, we had to know, no? So, always not is added in between helping verb and been. See the structure for negative sentences in past perfect continuous tense. Subject plus had plus not plus been plus V4 plus object. We'll see one example according to this. He had not been studying since morning. He had not been studying since morning. That is negative sentence. Now, interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences means questions. The structure should be had plus subject plus been plus V4 plus object in past continuous tense. Yes. Often, interrogative sentences means questions. In questions, often we had to use helping verb at the beginning of the sentence and it is followed by the subject. The helping verb in past perfect continuous tense is had. We'll see one example. Had they been working? Had you been doing any work during the last 2 hours? Had you been doing any work during last 2 hours? So, in the past, we are asking about, in the past, we are asking now about the past, isn't it? Had you been doing any work during the last 2 hours? So, before I asked you, you might have completed that work or not, I am asking you now. These are called interrogative sentences. Now, we will see the uses. It is very easy. This tense is very easy because no more rules will be there to use this. Tense only one uses, that is, it is used to express an action that had been going on happening before another past action. It is used to express an action that had been going on happening in the past
before another action took place in the past itself. That is the usage, that is the rule to use this past perfect continuous tense. For example, I'll explain you here. See, this is the whole is past tense. In this past tense, first work is here, second work is here. The first work had been going on before the second work took place. The first work had been going on in the past before another work took place. Is it clear? We'll see one example. The little baby had been crying when I saw her. These two actions took place in the past itself. Saw, I saw, it is past tense. Had been crying also past tense. So, these two actions took place in the past tense, but the first action had been continuing or going on or happening before another work took place. Before I saw her in the past, the little baby had been crying. The little baby had been crying when I saw her. Before another work took place in the past, the first work had been going on. That is the uses of past perfect continuous tense. Now, the difference between these two. See the difference between these two. What are those? Past perfect and past perfect continuous tense. See the difference. Past, in past tense, this is the line of past tense. In past tense, I'm telling you about past perfect. In past tense, first work, second work. The first work had completed before a new work, another work took place. The first work had completed at a particular period of time before new work, another work took place. That is past perfect. Past perfect continuous means in past tense, the first work had been going on or else had been happening before another work took place. In past tense itself, two works had been taken place. See, the first work had been going on or happening before another work took place in the past. That is past perfect continuous. Here, the first work had completed at a particular period of time. In this past perfect continuous tense, the first work had been going on continuous in the past itself before another work took place. That is the difference between past perfect and past perfect continuous tense. We'll see the structure once. Structure is subject plus, helping verb plus, been plus, V1 plus, inform plus, object. With I, we, you, they, he, she, it, we had to use only had. Is it clear? In the next lesson, we'll learn about future tense, that is simple future first. Thank you.